In this video, we will learn how to upload a DICOM into the MSOFT software, confirm that the data is according to the protocol and may be used, and check the feasibility for implant placement in terms of bone structure and volume. Our example will be a single implant to be placed in the lower jaw. This is the main screen in MSOFT. Click on the Upload DICOM Data control and upload the patient's CBCT. The upload may take several minutes depending on the size and number of files. Once the upload is complete, you will see this screen. The screen is divided into four viewing windows. In the upper left, you can see the 3D view. In the upper right, the frontal view is represented by a blue frame. In the lower left, we can see an axial view represented by a green frame, while in the lower right, we have the sagittal view represented by a red frame. Each 2D window will have two surfing planes. The color of the surfing planes will coincide with the frame color. Moving a surfing plane in one of the 2D views will move the plane in the other 2D windows correspondingly. In order to move a surfing plane, hover over it to activate it. An activated surfing plane will turn bright yellow when the cursor is touching it. We will move the surfing planes and surf the implantation site to inspect the bone quality and measure the bone. When a surfing plane is activated, press Shift in order to rotate the axis. The cursor wheel will allow you to zoom in and out. The measure tool is found in all three 2D slice views. Touch the measuring wheel with the cursor to activate it. Its color will change to bright yellow. While activated, drag the measure tool to the position of interest and measure. Each line is 1 millimeter. Red and green is the buccal to lingual width. Blue and green is your bone depth. Red and blue is the mesiodistal width. Once we have verified that there is sufficient bone volume for the implant and that the CBCT is done according to the protocol with sufficient field of view and no patient movements, we can press the flashing purple Save button on the upper side of the screen. If for any of the reasons mentioned above the data is not acceptable, do not save the plan and exit. Once saved, the MSOFT will show this data window. Let's review it. The first option is the default choice. The second option is not relevant since we do not intend to export the CBCT for manufacturing purposes. The third option will only be chosen in cases where you want to save the CBCT in STL format. In this section, you will choose the jaw that will be planned in this case. Note, each case in MSOFT may be planned for one jaw only. If your patient needs implantation in both jaws, you will need to create two separate cases in MSOFT. The same CBCT may be uploaded twice, once for each jaw. In this case, we are planning in the lower jaw. Insert the patient's surname, first name, and their date of birth. MSOFT will automatically create the system ID and the patient ID codes. Fill out the surgery date from the drop-down box. Auto-upload to server. This will ensure that the case data will be saved on your server for up to 7 years, and you can find it at any time in case of a technical problem. When the case is shared only to your computer, the case will be marked with a yellow rectangle. When the case is also shared to your server, it will also be marked with a light blue rectangle. If you also share your case with another MSOFT user or an MCenter, the case will also be marked with an orange rectangle. If all three options are done, the case will be marked with all three rectangles. Once we have completed to upload and save the data, we are ready to start working with the planning tool. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.